speaking of collusion, as we speak, you know, the ongoing House Justice Committee impeachment process against the Chief Justice. You know, it's been going on for months, 3 months maybe. Yes. And I know that you've spoken up on this, but how do you see this ending? And is this weakening the institution of the judiciary?
Well, as we have said, the IBP has said that impeachment is an extreme process. It's a process of last resort. That is because we want to protect the judiciary, for instance, from pressures from the other branches. Judges and justices are not politicians. No. They are appointed on the basis purely of merit and integrity. So once you apply pressure on them that is outside of that equation, you know, they will tend to also become political. They will try to gather support from the politicians. No? So as we said, it is an extreme measure and should be based only on the gravest sins that would amount to a flagrant violations of the Constitution. It should not be exercised haphazardly and for the smallest of reasons. That's why we have spoken. And so far I have not seen, in the entire length of the proceedings, except perhaps a 1 week point where the Supreme Court Chief Justice supposedly did not submit her salen from the time that she was a professor in law school. And if she can provide justifiable excuse for that, on the whole, I don't think there is any basis for that exercise of an extreme power.
So do you think that the judiciary can recover from this shock? I think it's a shock that tends to weaken the institution. In the future, you think that judiciary will recover from this, the use of impeachment as not as an extreme or last resort, but they just use it like it were an everyday tool.
I hope that the judiciary can recover, but ultimately it's the people who compose the institution, and it's up to the Supreme Court whether it should unite as an institution and rally behind their leader. But as we have seen, even the justices have chosen to testify openly against the Chief Justice.
This is a